Okay friends, now coming towards the next concept, which is your partnership deed. Okay, first of all, what we mean by partnership? Partnership is basically the voluntary association of people who came together with a common motive, right? That is sharing profit as well as losses and managing the firm, right? Okay, now if two or more persons are basically coming together for forming a partnership, it's obvious that there should be some agreement on the basis of which they both are going to perform, right? This agreement is what? This agreement is basically a contract which carry all the terms and conditions and all the aspects concerning the partner is essential to do. Partners are essential to perform. Okay. Now, if we will discuss about this agreement can either be oral or written. Even though there is no such compulsion that this agreement should be written or oral, but it is advisable to have an agreement on written basis. Why so? Because in case you are having an agreement on written basis, then it's obvious that at the time of conflicts arise, there this written agreement will help to be proved as the evidence of your partnership, and the level and the terms and condition you have specified will be basically we will have a proof, right? And as if you are having a proof, then it's obvious that the chances of conflicts will get reduced. And if we talk about this partnership deed, so we can define this partnership deed as this written agreement. So defining the partnership deed, we can say the written agreement which specifies all the terms and conditions that governs the partnership, are called partnership, is called partnership deed. Okay, say let's take an example. Say being two persons A and B came together with the same motive, being even though they are best friends today, but after 2 years or 3 years, what happen is some conflict arise, and B says, being partner of 10% or say 40% partner, and here he is a 60% partner, but B now is now wants to make some basically engaged in some frauds, and they say that there was 50% of partner he was, okay, but it's then in that case A will having loss of 10%, right? So in case they were having a written agreement, then in that case what will happen is he will be able to show the proof of the share of his contribution and the profit and losses he will gonna incur, okay? Now this partnership deed, in case it is written, will be known as partnership deed. Now coming towards the items which are carried in that partnership deed are, so the items included in the partnership deed are name of firm, first of all, that is at the top you will see the name of the firm from which the partners belongs, okay? Second thing is nature of business and location of business, okay? Next thing is duration of your partnership. Duration of business or partnership. That is, till what time and from what time you have started and you are going to add up the partnership deed. Okay. The next one is investment, which is very important. That is the contribution of capital made by each partner. That is, in that A is having 10,000, B is having 20,000. So total capital is your 30,000. It's not just 30,000 you can write. You are required to write the share of each partner. The next one is distribution of profit and loss. Distribution or the share of profit and losses, they are agreed upon. Okay. Coming toward the next, it is the duties and obligation. Duties and obligation of partners. They are required to perform. We have discussed here that they are having the capital of 10,000 and 20,000. So we can say, let's say they were decided to share the profit and loss 1:1. Even though they were having capital contribution, the B is having double contribution than of A, still they had discussed that the contribution will be 1:1. Now, if we will discuss about the duties, it's obvious as if A will gonna earn more profit as compared to B, as if he had to introduce capital of 10,000, still he will gonna earn 15,000 in case there is no profit or losses, and 15,000 as well by B. So it's obvious that as if A is going to earn more profits, it's also possible. It's possible only in case he is having more duties and obligation than B, right? So we can say that in case of duties as well, A, in case he is contributing less, it's obvious that the duties and obligation on A will be more. Okay. The next one is salaries and withdrawals of the partner. Okay, what are the salaries and how much they can withdraw at a particular period of time. The next one is terms governing admission, that is how one can admit a new partner or how one can take retirement of the firm. Okay. Next one is, or you can say partner. Next one is interest on capital. That is the interest on the capital you have introduced in the business. So it's obvious for a firm, it is a liability. Capital. Or interest on drawing, that is the income for the firm, as if it had provided you some benefit. The next one is procedure of dissolving. Procedure of dissolution. That is at the time of death, how the firm will be dissolved of the firm. Next one is preparation of accounts and their auditing. Preparation of accounts and its auditing. And the next one and the last one is your method of solving dispute, which is very important, and this is the main reason one is required to have method of solving dispute. This is why one is required to have a written deed, right? Dispute. To protect oneself from disputes, one is required to have a written deed. Okay, friends, so this is all about your partnership deed and the items involved under the partnership deed. Okay, for further classes, please download our app, Scholars Learning. And in case you have already downloaded our app, hope you guys are able to make your learnings easy. Hope you guys are able to get the classes enjoyable. Thank you.